Hello, loved ones. Welcome to this Smile Your Black presentation. We make them short, entertaining, and cultural because we know how it is when you're browsing social media. Most people don't want to spend a lot of time looking at one video, nor do people want to watch a 30-minute video just to get a small bit of information out of it that they were looking for. Today we're going to talk about a truly brilliant ancient cosmological theory from the Ancient Kingdom of Kongo. Before we get started, I'd like to remind you to subscribe to our channel and visit our Pan-African research and study blog at www.smileyourblack.com to take advantage of our free online encyclopedia of heroic African legacies, view all our videos, which are also available right here on Black Junction, and follow us on Twitter. The ancient kingdom of Congo dates back to the 14th century BC. That's between the years 1400 BC and 1301 BC. To put it another way, sometime between the life of Pharaoh Amenhotep III and Menmatra Seti I of Kemet, the Bantu Kongo were on the other side of the continent in Central Africa studying the origins of the universe. In this video, on Bantu Kongo Cosmology, we're going to explain their theory on how the universe started. No one really knows the exact origin of the universe, nor does anyone fully understand God or man's relationship to God. Humanity has to figure these things out on their own. Some people turn to religion for answers to these questions, some turn to science or a little bit of both. The Bantu Kongo turned to cosmology. Cosmology is the scientific study of the form, evolution, etc. of the universe. The branch of metaphysics dealing with the origin and structure of the universe, Webster's New World Dictionary 4th edition. Take note that evolution is a word that is used interchangeably in reference to a changing process or development, or in reference to the evolutionary theory of the origins of life. When it comes to trying to understanding Bantu Kongo cosmology, a holistic application of the word evolution may be applied. Bantu Kongo cosmology sought to answer the origins of all things in the universe, including life and death, and how all things are connected. They gave it a good shot, ladies and gentlemen, because much of what they said is still relevant today and has been reformulated in the Big Bang Theory. The research of our ancient African ancestors is such a critical part of the Big Bang Theory. It's fair to say, if the wisdom of the Bantu Kongo was not bestowed on humanity, the Big Bang Theory absolutely would not exist today. What the Bantu Kongo theorized is, in the beginning there was Mbangi. Mbangi means the emptiness and nothingness. The Bantu Kongo used charts and graphs to illustrate Mbangi. The circle and the square represent the same thing, a world with nothing in it and no visible form. On one side of the line is the physical side of the world, and on the other side of the line is the spiritual side of the world. One side cannot exist without the other, just like time cannot exist without space, nor the yin without the yang. It takes both sides to make the whole. Please take note of how the word world is used. It really falls short of the meaning of Mbangi, because Mbangi is the absence of anything. It is the absence of the universe. The universe came with a force known by the Bantu Kongo as Kalunga. Muntu, meaning humans, can exist on both sides of this line, so Muntu never really dies. When they are not on the physical side of the line, they are on the spiritual side waiting to return to Kunseke, the physical or the community. The Bantu Kongo theorized, one day, Kalunga, a fire force, appeared in Mbangi and exploded. Huge masses of very hot matter, going through fusion, sprayed in every direction and filled the eternal emptiness of Mbangi. As the masses of matter cooled, they fused, creating everything in the universe. From the perspective of the Bantu Kongo, all the stars, moons, and suns were created from the fusion of the matter as it cooled. The Bantu Kongo thought all the stars, moons, and suns were other worlds, and Muntu, humans, was only capable of inhabiting certain worlds. Kalunga is known to the Bantu Kongo as an omniscient force of eternal change and an eternal source of life that will generate forever. Everything in Kalunga becomes part of the life source of Kalunga, will always be in motion, and will always change. The concepts of Kalunga and Mbangi are far more complex than what was discussed here. All this discussion sought to do is discuss how the Bantu Kongo theorized the beginning of the universe. A complete understanding of Bantu Kongo cosmology would also reveal ideas that mirror what many scientists today call a space-time continuum. This cosmological theory of the Bantu Kongo is explained in greater detail in African Cosmology of the Bantu Kongo by Kimbawandende Kia Bunseki Fu Kiao, Ph.D.